I'm back with part three. And what I was talking about with part two, is should doubt be in our minds? Excuse me. Basically, should doubt be in our minds? The question would be no. Because as I was reading before in Deuteronomy 10, verses 20, fear the Lord your God and serve him, hold fast to him and take your oaths in his name. Take your oaths in his name. So if we look at this, is if we are hearing the Lord Jesus Christ, we are hearing him in our hearts, we are listening, and we know we should give our lives to the Lord Jesus Christ. And this is where it says, take oath in his name. But remember, it says up here, as it's saying, for your own good. So in verses 13, and to observe the Lord's commands and decrees that I'm giving you today for your own good. And this is where I was saying, if we have an altar call, and when we have this altar call, what happens is, we go, well, okay, we finished our sermon, da-da-da, and at the end of the day, I'd like that if people would like to come out to the mercy seat, would like to come out and, you know, just pray or seek something from God. But there's one key that we're missing, is that before we do this, we've got to realise that we are doing what, the same as what we're talking about before. We obey our parents, we do what our parents tell us to do when we're children. And when we come to the Lord Jesus Christ and we step out of darkness into light and we say, well, okay, I accept you as my Saviour, I accept you as Lord Jesus Christ of my life, then we have a new Father, and that is God. God is the gardener and Jesus is the vine. And we connect to Jesus Christ because we go through Jesus Christ. And are we going to know? And as he says in verses 13, and to observe the Lord's commands and decrees that I'm giving you today for your own good. And now, O Israel, what does the Lord your God ask for you but to fear the Lord your God, to walk in all his ways, to love him and to serve the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. See, the question is that when you go out in front of other Christians in church, remember this. You've got to do this because you fear the Lord your God and you want to serve the Lord and you want to be a servant of God and you want to love him with all your heart and with all your soul because you are remembering that God has set a decree with you today. And the good thing is that when you go out the front, as it says in Deuteronomy 10 verses 17, for the Lord your God is a God of gods and the Lord of lords and the great God, almighty and awesome, who shows no partiality and accepts no bribes. So God will not accept any bribes. So in the congregation you're listening to the pastor and you're going, well, God, if you do this for me, well, then what do I get out of it? Come on, I can bribe you with this. No, he will not accept no bribes. And there's no partiality. Basically, he sees all of us as sinners. There is only one way and one way only, and that is to Jesus Christ. There is one way. The narrow gate is the way to the Lord Jesus Christ. The narrow gate is to life. The broad gate, the broad way, it leads to destructions and leads to the things of this darkness. And if you've been in darkness for a long time and you're wondering to yourself, wonder why I'm in darkness, and you're hearing God right now, and remember, God doesn't show partiality. He doesn't say, well, okay, Jane, you can have this, and David, you can have this. No. Sin is sin. All sin is sin. We're all sinners. I'm a sinner. We're all sinners. So when we look at all this, we have to look that God's not going to accept bribes. Well, I'm a pastor. Come on, God, you can give me this. No. God will give you in his own time and through God's will when you are ready and when God believes. But you've got to have faith and you've got to believe as well. circumcised. Deuteronomy 10 verses 16, circumcise your hearts, therefore do not be stiff-necked and any longer, for the Lord your God is God of gods and the Lord of lords, and great and mighty and awesome, who shows no partiality except no bribes. If you're stiff-necked, as it's saying there, what a word, so there you go there, if, where are we looking at, for God, Lord and awesome, shows no partiality. See, this is what I'm saying. Hearts, stiff-necked no any longer. If you're stiff-necked, then you need to come to God. If you're stiff and you just think, well, I can go this way and I can go that way. No. You have to focus towards Jesus Christ and focus on God. Then you realize. In verses 18 of Deuteronomy 10, he defends the cause of the fatherless and the widows and loves the aliens, giving him food, clothing. And you are to love those who are aliens, for yourselves were aliens in Egypt. Remembering where you had come from before you became a Christian, before you accepted Jesus Christ. Remember, you were an alien as well. And you were from darkness, you were from this world, but you listened and you chose to obey the Lord's decrees, to love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, to fear the Lord. But how many of us have heard and told us by other people, it is for your own good, and do we listen? No. We think we're right. We think we're right. But are we right? Is right wrong? Is right and wrong is wrong? We think about it. And we can ponder it. Have we ever heard that saying? Other people say, see, I told you were wrong, or see, I told you were right. It is for your own good, as Jesus Christ is saying here. In verses 13 of Deuteronomy 10, and to observe the Lord's command and decrees that I'm giving you today for your own good. Deuteronomy 10 verses 17. For the Lord your God is a God of gods and the Lord of lords and great God and mighty and an awesome, who shows no partiality and accepts no bribes. We've seen in this the only one way is to Jesus, and that's following the narrow path. And this is what I was talking about. So we all can turn our Bibles. All turn our Bibles to Matthew 7. Matthew 7 verses 13 and 14. Enter through the narrow gate, for the wide gate and the broad road that leads to destruction. And many enter through it, but the small is the gate and the narrow road that leads to life, and only few find it. Only few find it. I'm going to leave it there, and when I come back I'm going to touch on this subject, but do we allow doubt? Should we doubt be in our minds? Should there be doubt in our minds? That is a question. Let's ponder. I'll go to part 4.